dear colleague from Tunisia, ladies and gentlemen. You've heard visa-free access to Tunisia, please go, wonderful country. We all have been there from Germany already. So, I don't know if I'm an interesting person. You have to see and judge yourself. I'm here and I accepted this invitation, first of all, because I wanted to reboost our relationship with the government of Chhattisgarh. Secondly, I'm here because I'm also civil, normal citizens like you, and I've lived in India now 3 years, and whenever I go back the last 3 years into Germany, I found out something which you all know, the climate change. Our summers are getting hotter, your time of heat is getting hotter and longer. When it rains, it gets more volatile. The winds we normally had are thunderstorms, heavily bringing hail instead of rain, doing destroying. I can see the climate change in our country, that the pine trees are dying because of what scientists say is only 1% increase in temperatures over the year. But the last years have been a wake-up call, and we all know, and you know it better, we really don't need really Greta going around. But Greta is very helpful because she reminds certain politicians we should not ignore facts. So I'm also here because I'm a strong believer that we have to do something to build a more sustainable, more environmental friendly for all of us, and this also starts with cities. But I'm also here because I represent Germany, a country which has long historic roots of friendship and partnership with India. So we have first offices opened up in 1854, but of course the first Germans came here with the Portuguese. So they were lacking academic expertise, so they invited German linguists, German botanics coming here and help to study, and that is why you find even today the highest number of faculties on Indology and on with experts on India in all areas in Germany. But we also have very strong academic relationships. Germany has now the higher number of Indian students than UK in Germany. The highest number of highly educated skilled workforce are the Indians in Germany. These are facts which go unknown. And nobody knows that Germany has been taught in India for more than 105 years. If you go to the city of Pune, more than 25,000 live there and speak there, a huge wide resource for German companies. That brings me to the economic relations. It's not that just we hear me, myself, consulates or the embassy. No, we have a presence of more than 1,600 German companies, which generate more than 1 million jobs in India. We are here, have more than 500 joint ventures. The world's largest foreign chamber of commerce is the Inter-German Chamber of Commerce here in India with 6,000 members. So we are well strategically already here with structures. And of course, politically, we also have something what we call strategic relations. What does it mean? It means we don't have not on and off some visits of our head of state, no. Our governments have agreed more than 20 years ago to see regularly institutionalized. It means every 2 years, our prime minister and new prime ministers come and sit together, not alone, but with the whole cabinet, and we have always a kind of agenda where they come together and work on certain areas. The discussions we are having with India range from trade to skill development to cybersecurity, climate change, terrorism, and we have many, many agreements and working groups established. We are also working together on to express the goals which have been expressed in the United Nations Urban Agenda for sustainable urban development. This, of course, has been turned, whilst talking how to make a sustainable future for us, has become one of the priority areas of bilateral cooperation. And we have promised to spend until 2022 €1 billion per year for this development. It was mentioned during the past decade, the number of Indian towns and cities with over 5,000 inhabitants have grown rapidly. It's not only those who already have reached the million barrier, also the smaller towns are increasing. And United Nations estimates that by 2031, it will reach more than 600 million in India will live in big towns. This must new challenges for you planning the towns and creating your environment and structuring it. If I look to India, of course, you have policies, right? You have the Clean Up India mission, you have the Atal mission for innovation of urban transformation, and of course, also your government has declared smart cities a priority. And But what we see, it's easy to formulate those goals. However, worldwide, when you formulate policy goals, the administrations of the cities all over are facing the challenges of limited expertise, manpower, experience, and also funds to fulfill the objectives of the initiatives. Our inter-German development cooperation is trying to bridge this gap with the money we are talking about, which will be earmarked and can be used until 2022. Today, the political, economic, and geopolitical importance of India reflects also India's development. India plays a crucial role not only with regards to economic and political stability in South Asia, but also when it comes to finding solutions to global and structural challenges, as mentioned, as climate change and environmental degradation. And that's why we really focus on India, because also we try to do our best. But of course, it doesn't help much if we reduce our emissions, if we get rid of atomic power as we did, if we have a long-term goal to abandon coal consumption and be a country of renewable industries. Germany is just too small. But we strongly believe that we start ahead and go ahead. We transform our societies in a really model role. We first of all can develop technologies and we can set a sample for the world. Germany alone cannot do it, but I think if we will have a movement all over the world having sustainable and economic, environmental, urban centers, we will make an impact. In India, what we do in concrete. With our technical corporations and the cooperation with the government, India has focused on 100 smart cities projects. Germany has picked out of these 100 cities, the city of Bhubaneswar, Kochi, and Coimbatore, as to start with to cooperate. With the German experience, we will focus on to create know-how and to help the local administrations to develop capacities and technologies to do their city planning. We are focusing on these few cities only, but it goes with understanding that all the knowledge now created and learned by this process will be shared with other cities. I'm here now also because I know that we have a very ambitious mayor and commissioner, and the commissioner also understands German institutions, and I'm here now also to offer and try to reconnect the city with initiatives we are doing. We have a national workshop on sustainable city on a national level. I think also Raipur should join. We have institutions here like Fraunhofer Institution, which is a German government-funded research body, who has opened the office in Bangalore, which will offer support on how to conceptualize, structure holistically smart city concepts, also will help to find the newest technology and also give consultations how to find finance if needed. Moreover, we have an initiative which is here in the country, is a MOU signed by CII on a national level with quite some industries, and here the German companies Siemens and Bosch are the major leader when it comes to smart cities technologies, and I'm also looking forward to connect Raipur with this initiative. Having that, of course, I would like to end with a wish that this initiative and you coming here together will give an important boost to the development of Raipur, which is already under the way to be a sustainable smart city. And I hope also fully that what we need here is that with also with your expertise that will give a boost for more political courage to the political leaderships, because in the very end, technologies and even finances around, what we need is regulations and legislation. That with goes to our grounds I'd like to address, and maybe we'll also discuss it with the chief minister this afternoon. That is needed all over, and also here I'm looking forward that also here we might have some expertise on how to legislate. But all I've said that, I wish you all the very best. I think it's the best way when people come together, exchange ideas. I've seen there many other cities are people here, And also the professor here has been very knowledgeable ideas about the future of traffic. All this is true, all this is happening in different states, and better have to prepare it. And you also have a unique change here, chance here, because you're not only refitting an existing city, but also have opportunity to restructure something for the future, the new greenfield city of how's it called, Naya Raipur. All the best to you.